Assalomu alaykum, hurmatli teletomoshabinlar, hurmatli yoshlar. Bugun tarjima nazariyasi va amaliyoti fanidan tarjimaning leksik masalalari mavzusidagi teledarsni boshlaymiz. Bu dars uchun mavzu tarjimaning leksik masalalari, tarjimaning lexical problems of translation mavzusiga murojaat qilamiz. Lexical problems of translation. We know that lexical level of English language is one of the richest. It has more than million words. About 30% of those lexical units are easy to translate from English into Uzbek. So in this lecture, we discuss the problems of rendering lexical units from English into Uzbek or vice versa, from Uzbek into English. So, due to the semantic features of language, the meaning of words, their usage, their combinability, associations awakened by them, the place they hold in the vocabulary are differentiated in translating languages. So, different kinds of lexical units, for example, English proper names, geographical denominations, terminological words, easy to translate from English into Uzbek. It's impossible to embrace all the cases of semantic differences between two languages. We shall restrict this course to the most typical features. The principal types of lexical correspondences between two languages are as follows. As you see, complete correspondence, partial correspondence, absence of correspondences. Complete correspondence, proper names, geographical denominations can be completely correspond. For example, the words like London, Uzbekcha, in Uzbek London, the USA, America Qo'shma Shtatlari AQSh, the Lake Superior or Pacific Ocean. The example shows that proper names and geographical denominations completely correspondences in English and Uzbek languages. Scientific and technical terms, with the exception of terminological polysemy, philosophy, damping, inflation, physics, astronomy, which are borrowed from classical languages, Greek and Latin, completely correspondence. Also, names of the months, days of the week, numerals in English and Uzbek languages completely correspond. Another group of correspondences can be found in partial correspondence. While translating English lexical units into Uzbek, we can face with partial correspondence. They are usually polysemantic words. For example, house, the word house in English, it's a building. Beside this, in the word combination of phrase, House of Representatives, it means another meaning. In Uzbek, it's Palata, Vakillar Palatası. Same similar example can be found in the word table, round table, it's a table, Uzbek in Uzbek stol. Table in Excel, Excel-dagi jadval. In this example, this word has another meaning, jadval. To invite to the table, dasturxonga marhamat. So, the word table has three meanings. Synonym is ordo, also partially corresponds. For example, this means discharge. It's an example of literary bookish style. İşten boşaltmak in adabi tilde, in colloquial words, it's sack, fire, işten haydamak. So, the edge of the table. The word edge means çete, kırası. The rim of the moon, oynin kırası. Picture of the word is known as various principles of dividing reality into parts. Hot milk, skin on it. Kaymak tutken ıssık süt. In this word, skin and kaymak are partially correspondence. So, though the word skin, literally word for word, it's not a kaymak in Uzbek. To swim, human being, to sail, to float. It means in this semantic row, we can see that swim belongs to human, to sail, to ship, to float inanimate object. In Uzbek, they have only meaning, süzmak. Another group of correspondence is absence of lexical correspondence. Absence of lexical correspondence is very often we can meet while translating English lexical units from English into Uzbek or from Uzbek into English. Realia are words denoting objects, phenomena, and so on, which are typical of people. The following groups of words can be regarded as having no equivalents. rarely of everyday life words denoting objects, phenomena, etc., which typical of people. For example, the word cab, fireplace are the rarely of English everyday life. Proper names and geographical denominations also can be found, can be example of absence of lexical correspondence. For example, in besides, addresses of greetings also differ from in English and Uzbek languages. Sir, Lord, Assalamu alaikum, and other forms, they have no lexical correspondences. The titles of journals, magazines, and newspapers also have no lexical correspondences. Ways, line measures, and etc. For example, foot, mile, barrel, inch, dyum in Uzbek, chakram, khadok has no equivalences or lexical correspondences. Below are three principal ways of translating words denoting specific realia. They are lexical substitution, supplementation, omission. Lexical substitution. In substitutions of lexical units, words and stable words combinations are replaced by others which are not their equivalents. More often, three cases met with. A concrete definition, replacing a word with a broad sense by one of a narrower meaning. For example, in Uzbek, he is at school. U maktabda o'qiydi. He is at school. He is in the army. U armiyada xizmat qiladi. Demak, he is in the army. Sözma-söz, u maktabda yoki armiyada emas, o'qiydi, xizmat qiladi kabi so'zlar bilan almashtirishga to'g'ri keladi. Another type of lexical transformation is generalization, replacing a word's narrow meaning by one with broad sense. For example, Navajo blanket. We don't have such kind of word in Uzbek, so we translate it into Uzbek Jun adyol adyala. In Russian, indiyski adyala. It means that Navajo, the word Navajo, cannot be translated into Uzbek directly. Another type of lexical transformation, an integral transformation. In integral transformation, the whole structure of the sentence changes. How do you do? Salam. So you can see here, how do you do this? Whole sentence changed into salam in Uzbek. Another type of lexical transformations, antonyms translation. It's antonyms translation is a complex lexicographical substitution of a positive construction for a negative one and vice versa, which is coupled with replacement of word by its antonym when translated. For example, keep off grass. Maysa ustida yurmay. The first sentence, keep off grass, is positive, whereas in Uzbek, we translated into Uzbek with negative sentence. Maysa ustida yurmang. Another example, remember, the enemy is listening to you. Remember is a positive sentence. We translate it, unutma, negative sentence. Unutma, düşman seni kuzatyapti. So the words remember and unutma in Uzbek are antonyms. Another type of lexical transformation is compensation. Compensation is used when a certain element in the original text cannot be expressed in terms of a language it's translated into. In cases of this kind, the same information is communicated by other as to make up the semantic deficiency. For example, he was ashamed of his parents because they said he don't and she don't. U o'z ota-onasining talaffuz qilishdan uyalardi, chunki ular so'zlarni noto'g'ri talaffuz qilardilar. In English, he don't and she don't are grammatically incorrect sentences, so use it compensation method and noto'g'ri talaffuz qiladilar is used for it. Another type of lexical transformation is supplementation. Supplementation, a formal inexpressibility of semantic components, is the reason most met with the using supplementation as a way of lexical transformation. A formal inexpressibility of certain semantic components is especially of English word combinations, noun plus noun, adjective plus noun, etc. For example, pay claim, ish haqini oshirish talabi. Pay claim in English has two components. In Uzbek, ish haqini oshirish talabi, it has four components. Another example, logical computer, logic operatsiyalarni bajaruvchi computer. Logical computer has two components, whereas in Uzbek it has four components. So we can observe here supplementation also. Another type of lexical transformation is omission or dropping. In the process of lexical transformation of omission, generally words with a surplus meaning are omitted. Components of typically English pair synonyms, possessive pronouns, and exact measures in order to give a more concrete expressions. For example, to raise one's eyebrows, yalt etip karamok. Here we can see that once is omitted. So we said that different kinds of realia we can face while rendering English lexical units from into Uzbek or from Uzbek into English. So transliteration is used mostly while rendering realia. Cab, dup, sandal, izba in Russian. You can see these examples are bright examples of realia which are transliterated while rendering from English into Uzbek. Another type of rendering realia is creation of new single or complex word for denoting an object on the basis of elements and morphological relationships in the mother tongue. For example, skyscraper, Osman Öper. Use of a word denoting sometimes close to realia of another language. It represents an approximate translation specified by the context, which is sometimes on the verge of description. For example, peddler we can translate as tarkatuchi, though they are not synonymous or equivalents. So while rendering lexical units from English into Uzbek, we face different kinds of difficulties. For example, one and the same word can be translated differently. In the word combination public opinion, jamoatchilik fikri, in this word public is rendered as jamoatchilik. Public scandal, ommavi mojaro. Public debt is hukumat qarzi. You see that in three word combinations, one and the same word public is translated differently. So another group of words which we have, we call it false friends of translator. Or in some literature we use it pseudo-international words. They can be two different types. For example, the word clay. When Uzbek people hear that clay, they may understand clay, yelim in Uzbek. When magazine, English word magazine, can be translated sometimes magazine dokon, whereas it means journal. Besides, most words similar in pronunciation. For example, accept and accept, lose and lose. While rendering oral translation, orally we face these units in translation. At the end of this lecture, we should find the answers to the given questions. What are the principal types of lexical correspondence between two languages? Her iki tildagi leksik birliklarining moslikining asosiy turlari qaysilar? What lexical units are liable for complete lexical correspondence? Qanaqa leksik turdagi leksik birliklar to'liq tarjima qilinadi, to'liq mos keladi? What cases refer to partial lexical correspondence? Qanaqa holatlarda qisman mos kelish holati kuzatiladi? What is understood under lexical substitution? Leksik almashtiruv deganda nima tushuniladi? In what cases is supplementation is applied? Qaysi holatlarda so'z qo'shish hodisasi kuzatiladi? What are the cases of absence of lexical correspondence? Leksik jihatdan mos kelmaslik holatlari qaysi holatlarda kuzatiladi? Mustaqil o'qish uchun for self study the following topics are recommended: translation of terminological words, translation of polysemantic words, translation of proper names and geographical names, translation of realia and culture-bound words. Mustaqil o'qish uchun demak quyidagi mavzularni o'qish tavsiya qilinadi: terminologik so'zlarning tarjimasi muammosi, ko'p ma'noli so'zlar tarjimasi, atoqli otlar va geografik nomlar tarjimasi bilan bog'liq masalalar, realia, xos so'zlar va madaniyat bilan bog'liq leksik birliklarning tarjimasiga doir mavzularni qo'shimcha o'qish tavsiya qilinadi. This was the end of the lecture. Lexical problems of translation. See you next teleclasses. Goodbye.